Hello students, I hope you all are safe at home. So today we will start chapter number 4, how the traders became rulers. Now students, in the first chapter, that is arrival of Europeans in India. Europeans arrived in India for the trading purpose. But how those traders became the rulers? So by the mid of 18th century, the British had started to emerge as a strong power on the Indian political horizon. Do you know that the British came to India only for trade? And initially, they took the permission to trade in Indian state. Then how did they become the rulers of the entire India? The history of the British rule arouses many such questions. Because to serve their economic interests, they increased their political hold on India with the use of British diplomatic tactics. Now, Wellesley's policy of expansion. When Wellesley came to India as the Governor General, there was cutthroat competition existed between England and France. It was necessary to check France from becoming powerful in India. So as to expand the British rule in India, Wellesley introduced a new plan, which was known as the subsidiary alliances. Now student, you can underline this sentence. The question is asked, which plan was introduced by the Wellesley? So you have to write the answer, subsidiary alliance. As per the scheme, any princely state that accepted the alliance had to keep and maintain the British army as well as keep a British representative in the royal court. This way the British could maintain their army without spending any money. However, the princely states were not allowed to utilize the army at their own will. This system, which made many feel secure in the beginning, made them feel enslaved and threatened. Subsidiary alliance acted like a slow poison for the princely states of India. The Indian states that became the victims of the subsidiary alliance were Hyderabad, Mysore, Ayodhya, Jodhpur, Gaikwad of Vadodara, Peshwas of Pune, and Sindhias of Gwalior. Now, Nizam of Hyderabad was the first victim of Wellesley's subsidiary alliance. Now, student, you can underline this sentence. The question is asked, who was the first to become the victim of the Wellesley's subsidiary alliance? So the answer is Nizam of Hyderabad. Then it was Mysore and Ayodhya. Tanjore and Karnataka met with the same fate. The British made the Marathas fight among themselves and consequently made them accept the subsidiary alliance. Now, owing to the losses incurred by Nizam in his fight with Marathas, he was the first to accept this alliance. Tipu Sultan of Mysore refused to do so, but after the British victory in the Fourth Anglo-Mysore War, Mysore was forced to become a subsidiary state. Maratha chief fought among themselves. After the death of Nana Fadnavis, one by one, all the Maratha states became the victim of divide and rule policy of the British. The other states, namely Ayodhya, Gorakhpur, Tanjore, Karnataka, Farukabad, also suffered the same fate. In this way, within a span of 7 years, underline this sentence, Wellesley expanded the company rule and made the British the supreme power in India. Now you can see the picture of Lord Wellesley is given in your textbook and a battle fought by the Wellesley. Now the expansion of the British rule in India. After finalizing the subsidiary alliance treaties with Mysore, Nizam of Hyderabad and Maratha chieftains, the British moved towards northern part of India. They entered into a treaty of friendship with Nepal. Sensing a threat from it, they fought many battles to secure the frontiers. Friendly relations with the Sikh king Maharaja Ranjit Singh helped them to win the battle with the Afghans and establish their rule in Sindh. The British had an ambition to capture the Sikh kingdom, which was a very powerful kingdom, but they could not do so as long as Maharaja Ranjit Singh was alive. So they kept friendly relations with Maharaja Ranjit Singh. Ranjit Singh was a strong ruler of that time. He had set up a strong army with the help of European officers for the protection of his state. He had attained victories over many nearby states. After his death, Punjab suffered anarchy. Governor General Sir Henry Hardinge came to India and brought the Sikh rule completely under the British rule with policy of interference and annexation. Now, student, I will explain you the further topic in my next video. Thank you.